Hello there, morning everyone. Happy smiley Mr. Mitchell here, how are you? Tuesday, an absolutely beautiful looking Tuesday. Now, Tuesday, to most people, just another day of the week. Because it is just another day of the week, but it's not Monday. And that means the week is already getting a little bit better. But what else do we know about Tuesday? Well, I've been doing a bit of research about Tuesday. The word itself comes from an old English word called Tuesday, which means Tuesday. So Tuesday comes from an older word called Tuesday, which means Tuesday. Anyway, T-I-W was a Norse god, Vikings again. Anyway, he was a Norse god who was the god of combat, victory, and heroic glory. So, could easily have been called Mitchell's Day, couldn't it? But unlike Monday, which is the laziest day of the week, Tuesday is proven to be the most productive day of the week, which means it's the day on which we get the most done. In Greece and Spain, Tuesday is considered an unlucky day. But in the Jewish religion, it's the opposite. It's considered a very lucky day. According to one website that I looked at, Tuesday always falls between a Monday and a Wednesday. What else happens on Tuesdays? Well, the D-Day invasions took place on Tuesday. Pancake Day happens on a Tuesday. Pancake Day, or Shrove Tuesday, is the traditional feast day before the start of Lent on Ash Wednesday, which is a time of fasting. Now, they call it a feast day, don't get me wrong. I love a pancake, bit of sugar, lemon, lovely, but I wouldn't go so far as to call them a feast. Still, yummy all the same. What else happens on a Tuesday? Well, some Champions League matches take place on a Tuesday. The Champions League, of course, being the biggest football tournament in the world, and one in which the biggest football clubs from each country play against each other, such as Spain, you've got Barcelona, Juventus from Italy, you see where I'm going with this, Bayern Munich from Germany, Tottenham Hotspur from England. God, do you remember last year's Champions League run for Tottenham Hotspur, team of the tournament or what? What about that Lucas Moura hat-trick? And that was after the game against Man City, where we beat Man City over two legs, didn't we, Stephen? And Harry. What else? Well, of course, the smaller European clubs, they don't play on a Tuesday. They play in a much smaller competition called the Europa League, which takes place on a Thursday night. So much smaller clubs play, such as, well, let's think, Famagusta from Cyprus will play against people like Derry City from Ireland, will play against people like Barla Town from Wales, and Chelsea and Arsenal from England. Talking of football, it's statistically proven that Southampton definitely will have sold at least one of their best players to Liverpool on a Tuesday. And there's also evidence to suggest that Portsmouth fans like Mr. Hanlon will talk about their oh-so-amazing FA Cup win at least three times every single Tuesday. And they have done ever since it happened, whenever it was. What else do we know about Tuesdays? Well, do you know what? Not a lot. What have we learnt about Tuesdays of interest? Not a lot, but I get to see you again, and for that I thank Tuesday. Good to see you everyone, enjoy the rest of the broadcast.
Okay, so today, Baycroft, we're going to be doing some air guitar stretches. Now, you've probably not come across this before. That's because I've kind of just made it up off the top of my head. There's a lot of videos that we've had so far, and I've got to be thinking all the time. So, what you're going to do is you're going to put one arm out. You're going to turn side on the other arm. It's going to come down and around. Now, it kind of looks like you're playing an air guitar. What you're doing here is you're loosening up the muscles around your shoulder joint. So you're going to keep it going. And then we're going to swap, put the other arm out, and then we're going to do that. You can kind of go lower if you want to stretch your legs, but just keep those arms moving around. It's almost like stretching, a bit of butterfly stroke at the start of the swimming race. give it a go. See you later, Baycroft.
Good morning, Baycroft. I'm here today to continue our look at diversity and diversity in what it looks like in our community at Baycroft, but also what it looks like in our country and even the world at the moment. Now, today we're going to be focusing on George Floyd and the Black Lives Matter campaign. If you're not aware of what this means, watch this video from Newsround to get a little bit more information about what's going on.
You cannot put a price on a human life.
That could have been my dad or my brother, or it could have been me.
The only wrong thing to say is to say nothing.
No justice! No peace! No justice!
No peace! Everyone's really upset. The fact that another life has been taken.
This is the most important thing at this moment in time.
I think we should all be treated equally because in the end we're all people.
What I really would like is equality, and that when we grow up we don't have to do protests like this.
Black lives have always mattered!
And if people continue to die for no reason, I will continue to fight until that changes.
Now, racism is a word you may have heard a lot recently, but what does it actually mean? Well, it's when words or actions are used to discriminate or disadvantage people because of their colour, culture or ethnic origin. Well, today we're going to hear about George Floyd. But first, we head to Houston, Texas, the hometown of George Floyd. Last night, his family and friends gathered to remember him ahead of his funeral, which is happening later this evening. Well, how did an event in the city of Minneapolis spark a protest that spread right around the USA and the world? Here's Ricky.
These are just some of the protests that have been taking place across the world. They started in Minneapolis in America in response to the death of a man called George Floyd after he was detained by white police officers. The protests quickly spread to other parts of America because lots feel the way black people are treated by the police and racism in general are big problems in the US. But it's not just in America. Similar issues are faced by black people all over the world, and it's one of the reasons protests have now spread across the globe. Tens of thousands of people have taken to the streets across the UK as well, with many famous people joining in, including Star Wars star John Boyega.
Black lives have always mattered. We have always been important. We have always meant something. We have always succeeded.
Despite a sad event triggering these protests, many feel hopeful that people of all races and backgrounds in America and around the world are largely protesting peacefully and coming together to call for an end to racism and for all people to be treated the same.
As you can see, there's people all over the world campaigning for Black Lives Matter. Now, we know the colour of your skin doesn't mean that you should be treated any differently, but lots of people need to get their voices heard. That's really important and has been important throughout the whole of history, either if it's by a speech that they give or just a quote that represents their thoughts and feelings. So today's task is going to be you creating either a speech or a mini quote to suggest how you feel about the world today. For a little bit of inspiration, here are some black famous icons that have done exactly that task.
I refuse to accept the view that mankind is so tragically bound to the starless midnight of racism and war, that the bright daybreak of peace and brotherhood can never become a reality.
We declare our right on this earth to be a man, to be a human being, to be respected as a human being, to be given the rights of a human being in this society, on this earth, in this day, which we intend to bring into existence by any means necessary.
Soul has no color, no shape, no form. You have the power to change perception, to inspire and empower, and to show people how to embrace their complications and see the flaws and the true beauty and strength that's inside all of us.
That's right. I have wrestled with an elephant.
on the screen now, you'll see some sentence starters to help you achieve this task. Think about what you want your community to look like and what's important to you. So I had a go at it. It's really tricky to think about what's really important, and I decided that I believe the world should be a place where everyone should only be judged on their actions. So other people can only judge them if they've done something wrong, not by the colour of their skin, their appearance, or what they believe in. So send them in to the home learning email address. I'd love to be able to share some of your quotes with the rest of the Baycroft community.
Hi, Mr. West here, and welcome to another history lesson. I'm actually at Tichfield Abbey at the moment. The sun is shining, the birds are singing, and this is a very old building which is now a ruin, but it's had many interesting visitors in the past. Henry VIII, Elizabeth I, Edward VI have all come here. I'm actually standing in the exact place at the moment where the past King of England got married. Did you know it's free to visit Tichfield Abbey? Looking behind me, you can see some holes. These are where the floor joists used to be to support an upper floor. And now you can see a fireplace immediately behind me. Imagine what sort of meals they would have cooked here.
made one.
Hello, my name is Claire, and we're gonna do something really fun today. We're gonna make a tornado in a jar. All you need is four things. Any kind of dish soap, any kind of hand soap, any kind of vinegar, some water, and any kind of jar, and a lid for the jar. First, you add some water. Then, you get some soap. Just a little bit of that soap. Just dump it over, and then just a little bit. Then you have some vinegar here, and you just a little bit of vinegar. And then you put on the lid as tight as you can. You flip it over and then you shake it, and there you have a tornado. A tornado is a violently rotating column of air. Look, it looks like a funnel.
Yesterday's sign was chocolate. Today's sign is chicken. Chicken.
Hello, welcome back. Hope you've enjoyed your Tuesday broadcast. It's looking like an absolutely gorgeous day out there, so make sure you make the most of it, and we will see you once again tomorrow morning on Baycroft TV.